back to. We take it back to his sunnah, his traditions. And if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we take it back to his book, the Quran. And we say what both of them have said regarding this matter. And that is our judge. Your desires we do not want. Your desires we don't want. And my desires you don't want. What you want is what Allah and his messenger have to say. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said in another ayah, وَإِذَا قِيلَ also the ayah that I mentioned. So وَإِذَا دُعُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ when they are called to Allah and His Messenger to be judged between them إِذَا فَرِيقٌ مِّنْهُمْ مُعْرِضُونَ a group of them turn away. وَإِنْ يَكُمْ لَهُمُ الْحَقُّ but if what is being judged is in favor for them, if they know what is going to be judged is in favor for them, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, يَأْتُوا إِلَيْهِ مُذْعِنِينَ they come submitting. We want to listen now. When it's in their favor. But when they know, if they look in the book of Allah and the sunnah, rather it's going to be not their rights, it's going to be somebody else's rights, what's going to happen? He doesn't want to go to the book of Allah and the sunnah. He wants to follow his desires. Allah then says, أَفِي قُلُوبِهِمْ مَرَضْ is in their hearts illness. أَمِرْ تَابُوا or have they doubted about it? أَمْ يَخَافُونَ أَنْ يَحِيفَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ وَرَسُولُهُ بَلْ أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الظَّالِمُونَ do they not believe that this is from Allah and his messenger? Do they not believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to give protection to the Prophet and his messenger? Because the hypocrites, when they followed the Prophet, they only followed him because they thought their blood can be protected, or they can tell their followers and their lovers the reality of Muhammad's affairs. But they didn't know Allah is going to protect him and give him the upper hand. Also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said about the hypocrites and those who have who's got illness in their hearts. As'alullah rabbal arsh al-azim. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Lord of the thrones, أن يرزقنا الإيمان that Allah provides us truthful إيمان. Look what Allah said about them. وإذا قيل لهم تعالوا when it said to them, come إلى ما أنزل الله, come to that which Allah has sent down. وإلى الرسول and to the messenger, رأيت المنافقين يصدون عنك صدودا you find that the hypocrites, they turn away a turning from you. They don't want to listen. They don't want to hear anything. So brothers, what we have to understand is إيمان has benefits. And it has benefits that are ajila and ajila. Ajila means it takes place in this world. Ajila means it takes place in the hereafter. And I mentioned some of those benefits and those thamarat that it has. Now I'm going to finally conclude with the last point, which is a story of the people when iman went into their hearts, how it changed their lives. And how we may have been when the iman came to us, the way we act. I want to talk about the Sahara, the magicians of Fir'aun. When they believed in our Prophet Musa alayhi salam. I want to bring that to your attention, inshallah. They were people who were magicians for Fir'aun. High ranked, who loved Fir'aun. طلاب الدنيا. They were people who wanted the dunya, who ran after it. And they also what? Their himam, their aspiration was qasira. It was short. It was just this world, nothing but this world. يُحِبُّنَّ الشَّهْوَاتِ They love the desires. وَالْأَعْرَاذَ الدُّنْيَوِيَّ And worldly gain. That's all they wanted. And before the battle took place between them and Musa alayhi salam, they asked the one that they loved so most, Fir'aun. They said to him, أَإِنَّ لَنَا لَأَجْرَى Do we have a reward with you? Do we have what? Do we have a reward? إِن كُنَّا نَحْنُ الْغَالِبِينَ If we beat Fir'aun, Musa and his followers, and we put them to their knees today, will we have any reward from you? Will we get anything from you? Fir'aun said to them, قَالَ نَعَمْ Of course, you will. What is it? وَإِنَّكُمْ إِذَا لَمِنَ الْمُقَرَّبِينَ You will be very close to me. This is Fir'aun. Fir'aun, he was worshipped. قَالَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى Allah said, فَاسْتَخَفَّ قَوْمَهُ فَأَطَاعُوهُ He put fear and terror in the hearts of the people and they worshipped him. He was the one who said, أَنَا رَبُّكُمُ الْأَعْلَى I am your supreme Lord. Lays, he believed that he was, or he convinced the people that he was ilah. He put terror in their hearts. So for the magicians to be told, if they win today, فِرْعَوْن الْإِلَهُ الَّذِي يُعْبَدْ The ilah that is worshipped, for them that is a high rank. That's the way they looked at it and they perceived it. That today Fir'aun will bring them close. What did he promise them? A joy. very short, very little, very pathetic. He promised them, they were happy. They came to that place. The sihr that they had, they brought. And everything that they wanted to do. Musa alayhi salam came with him and his brother and his followers who followed him. And they came. Fir'aun, the magicians, they said to Fir'aun, with all conviction, no, having belief in themselves that today no one's going to beat them. They said to Musa and Harun, قَالُوا يَا مُوسَى أَوْ مُوسَى إِمَّا أَن تُلْقِيَ وَإِمَّا أَن نَكُونَ نَحْنُ الْمُلْقِينَ Musa, you are going to throw. In another ayah, in Surah Al-Taha, they said to him, قَالُوا يَا مُوسَى إِمَّا أَن تُلْقِيَ It is either that you throw, وَإِمَّا أَن نَكُونَ نَحْنُ وَإِمَّا أَن نَكُونَ أَوَّلَ مَنْ أَلْقَى Or we are going to be the first to throw. No, they're not scared. You want to go first or should we go first? And this is called ثِقَّةٌ مِنْ أَنفُسِهِمْ They had full conviction that today, get this job and done over with, get that position from Fir'aun, destroy Musa and everything he has to bring, and you guys have the upper hand. Musa alayhi salam, scared. He is scared. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks to him after. قَالَ لَهُمْ مُوسَى Musa says to them, أَلْقُوا Throw, you guys throw. مَا أَنْتُمُ الْقُونَ Throw what you are going to throw. فَأَلْقَوْا Then they said, okay, no problem. They went back and they threw. فَأَلْقَوْا حِبَالَهُمْ وَعِصِيُّهُمْ They threw their sticks. Whatever they had, they threw it. Their ropes and their sticks, they threw it. وَقَالُوا And then they said, look, بِعِزَّةِ فِرْعَوْنِ The honor of Fir'aun. إِنَّا نَحْنُ الْغَالِبِينَ We are the winners today. So when they threw it, they interceded. Or they actually worshipped and they spoke on the name of who? Fir'aun. بِعِزَّةِ فِرْعَوْنِ The power of who? Fir'aun. Ikhwatul Islam, brothers of Islam, religion. This is what they had. They did not leave anything behind that they could. They were ulama in this field. They put everything that they had. When they threw, what happened? قال الله تعالى الله said فلما ألقوا when they threw سحروا أعين الناس the people's eyes were mazed. They deluded the people. The whole place became their magic. واسترهبوهم وجاءوا بسحر عظيم and they put fear in the hearts of the people. And Allah said it. Allah said it. And they came with a big magic. Not something small. وَجَاءُوا بِسِحْرٍ عَظِيمٍ عَظِيمٍ Allah referred to it as great. Something big is what they put to the table. What happened to Musa? فَأَوْجَسَ فِي نَفْسِهِ خِيفًا Musa found in himself fear. He got scared. And he was worried. How am I able to? The whole place was covered with their ropes. It became snakes. Demons. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, قُلْنَا We said to him, لَا تَخَفْ إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْأَعْلَى Don't be scared, Fir'aun. Don't be scared, Musa. For verily, you are the upper hand today. You are the higher one. You are the one that's going to live with the good result. Allah then said to him, وَأَلْقِ مَا فِي يَمِينِكَ And throw it in your right hand. تَلْقَفُ مَا صَنَعُ It will start to peck on each rope that they threw, one after the other. All of it. إِنَّمَا صَنَعُوا كَيْدُ سَاحِرٍ What they have done is just a plotting of a magician. وَلَا يُفْلِحُ السَّاحِرُ حَيْثُ أَتَى And magic, wherever it comes from, it will not be successful. Whatever magic does. With the Qur'an and the religion of Allah, wallahi, it will never lift a head. Nabiullah Musa alayhi salam when he threw his stick it started to take off every single thing that he had on the table it all went who did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give the win to Nabiullah Musa my goal from the story is not what happened between Musa and Fir'aun that has a lot of tafaseel a lot of explanations I want the magicians. How were they before the battle and how were they after? When they saw what Musa did to the magic that they presented and the work that they put to the table, and they were not, brothers, they were not just magicians. They were the greatest magicians to have ever walked on the earth that day. Lebillahi Musa alayhi salam, when him and Nabiullahi Musa and Fir'aun had the discussion, Fir'aun said to him, what? بَيْنَنَا وَبَيْنَكَ مَوْعِدًا لَا نَخْلِفُهُ نَحْنُ وَلَا أَنْتَ مَكَانَ السُّوَى يَوْمُ الزِّينَة. It was a day of celebration for the people of Ben Israel, the people of Fir'aun. The day of what? Zina, beautiful. Fir'aun requested for a year. And what did he do for that year? He brought all the magicians that existed, all of them, from the cities, from the towns, from the lives, all of them. This is the Nukhaba. These are the elite magicians that he handpicked, huh? Handpicked. And he brought them to their place. Even they believe that they're going to win. Because they believed just this one man or two men. But when they saw this, it baffled them. And you know what they realized? That this was not magic. Because they knew what magic was. They were the elite of magic. They knew that this wasn't magic. So what did they do? فَأُلْقِيَ السَّحَارَةُ سُجَّدًا. They fell into a position, the highest position a servant can fall into. Sujood. To who? To Allah. What was the first thing that they said? قَالُوا آمَنَّا. We believe. بِرَبِّ هَارُونَ وَمُوسَى. We believe in the Rabb of Harun and Musa. We believe in it. In another ayah, what did they say? فَأُلْقِيَ السَّحَرَةُ سَاجِدِينَ. All of them. They fell. The Mufassirin, they have Aqwal, all of them did it, but they prostrated. A great number of them prostrated and fell on the ground. What did they say? قَالُوا آمَنَّا بِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. We believe in the Lord of the heavens. رَبِّ مُوسَى وَهَارُونَ. And they emphasized it even more. The lower, the other one. The one Musa and Harun believe in. That's the one we believe in. قبل قليل. Just before a little bit, what were they saying? قالوا بعزتي. Just a little bit. Before the battle, they were saying, in the honor of who? Let's see when the Iman entered their hearts. What did it do to them? How did it react? How did they react? Fir'aun said to them, قالوا آمنتم به قبل أن آذن لكم. You believed in Musa and in whatever he bought before I gave you permission. إِنَّهُ لَكَبِيرُكُمُ الَّذِي عَلَّمَكُمُ السَّحْرِ. All this blame goes to the biggest one that taught you magic. فَلَسَوْفَ تَعْلَمُونَ. You will all know what will happen. لَأُقَطِّعَنَّ أَيْدِيَكُمْ وَأَرْجُلَكُمْ مِنْ خِلَافٍ وَلَأُصَلِّبَنَّكُمْ فِي جُذُوعِ النَّخْلِ. I promise that I will cut your hands and your legs off like this, one hand on the other hand. And I will hang you on the trees. Look at what Fir'aun said. وَلَتَعْلَمُنَّ أَيُّنَا أَشَدُّ عَذَابًا وَأَبْقَى. And you will know which one is more severe in punishment, me or the Lord of Musa. You will know. In another place, what did he say? وَأَرْجُلَكُمْ مِنْ خِلَافٍ وَلَأُصَلِّبَنَّكُمْ أَجْمَعِينَ. All of you, I will crucify you. What did they say? What did they reply? Well, look at the Iman when it enters the person's heart. قَالُوا لَا طَيْرٍ. Don't worry, no blame. Inna ila rabbina munqalibun. We are going back to Allah. It's He who we're going to meet. In another place, what did he say? قَالَ آمَنْتُمْ لَوْ قَبْلَ أَنْ آذَنَ لَكُمْ إِنَّهُ لَكَبِيرُكُمُ الَّذِي عَلَّمَكُمُ السِّحْرِ فَلَأُقَطِّعَنَّ أَيْدِيَكُمْ وَأَرْجُلَكُمْ مِنْ خِلَافٍ وَلَأُصَلِّبَنَّكُمْ فِي جُذُوعِ النَّخْلِ وَلَتَعْلَمُنَّ أَيُّنَا أَشَدُّ عَذَابُ وَأَبْقَى. قَالُوا لَنْ نُؤْثِرَ. From this minute onwards, it will not affect us. عَلَى مَا جَاءَنَا, or that which has come to us from the clear guidance. وَالَّذِي فَطَرَنَا, and that which Allah has made our basic instincts. فَقْضِي مَا أَنْتَ قَاضٍ. Fir'aun, do whatever you want. فَقْضِي. Judge and do whatever you wish. Do it. إِنَّمَا تَقْضِي هَذِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا. You will only be able to do it in this world. إِنَّا آمَنَّا بِرَبِّنَا. In his face, we believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why? ليغفر لنا. So Allah can forgive us خطايانا, our shortcomings and our sins that we did. وما أكرهتنا عليه من السحر, and that which you had forced us on, the magic. والله خير, Allah is the best. وأبقى, and Allah is the remaining. Allah then says, إنه من يأتي ربه, anyone who comes to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala مجرما, a criminal, فإن له جهنم, anyone who comes to Allah sinning as a criminal, for جهنم is his abode. لا يموت فيها, he will not die in جهنم, ولا يحيا, and he will not live in it. ومن يأتي مؤمنا, but anyone who comes to Allah in the state of iman, قد عمل الصالحات, this is what they're saying, look at this, anyone who comes with righteous actions, فأولئك لهم الدرجات العلا, for them is what? The highest ranks in Jannah. إخواني, بعزة فرعون, أئن لنا لأجرا, to what? قالوا لا طير, إنا إلى ربنا منقلبون. أما قالوا لن نؤثرك على ما جاءنا من البينات والهدى من بعد. All of this doesn't matter to us anymore. Doesn't concern us. It is the clear proof that we are going to now follow. And what did they say after all of that? They said, ربنا, oh our Lord, أفرغ علينا صبرا, spread amongst us patience, وتوفنا مسلمين, and take our life in a state of Iman and Islam. What also did they say? إِنَّا نَطْمَعُ أَن يَغْفِرَ لَنَا رَبَّنَا خَطَايَانَا, we wish that Allah forgives us for our sins. For our sins, أَن كُنَّا أَوَّلَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ, because of the fact that we are the first believers, the first patch of believers. So إخواني, that is the people who've tasted Iman. And they, Fir'aun promised them, he put them through. He destroyed them. But they still stood by it. And they did not move. When Iman enters a person's heart, they stick to it. Regardless of what the situation is. Regardless of what? Situation. Yes. Person gets stronger and stronger. The gold, when it's burnt, does it not then shine even more? The more the believer is tested, the more his Iman shines. And the more he becomes even more stronger and powerful. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he makes us true believers. Allahumma radd al-muslimina ila deenika raddan jameela. Oh Allah, bring back the people back to your religion the best way. Subhanaka Allahumma bihamdik, ashadu an la ilaha illallah, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayhi. I just wanted to mention one thing, inshallah. And we are in the 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. Just wanted to mention some benefits. Just one hadith, inshallah, and one kalam of our great scholar, Ibn Rajab al-Hanbali, rahimahullah. Al-Imam al-Bukhari narrated in his Sahih bin Hadith Abdullah ibn Abbas that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, مَا مِنْ أَيَّامِ الْعَمَلُ الصَّالِحُ فِيهَا أَحَبُّ إِلَى اللَّهِ مِنْ هَذِهِ الْأَيَّامِ يَعْنِي أَيَّامَ الْعَشَرِ قالوا يا رسول الله ولا الجهاد في سبيل الله قال ولا الجهاد في سبيل الله إلا رجلا خرج بنفسه وماله ثم لم يرجع من ذلك بشيء. This hadith, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, Bukhari narrated in his Sahih, Abdullah ibn Abbas is the companion who narrated from the Prophet, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, ما من الأيام, that there is no days of the days, العمل, that the actions are more righteous actions are more beloved to Allah than these days, these 10 days that we're in right now, which started today. The companions, they said, Ya Rasulullah, even jihad is not, these 10 days, the actions that your person does, even jihad, the Prophet said, وَلَا الْجِهَادُ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ, even jihad, except, إِلَّا رَجُلًا خَرَجَ بِنَفْسِهِ وَمَالِهِ, except a person who left with his wealth and his himself. ثُمَّ لَمْ يَرْجَعْ مِنْ ذَلِكَ بِشَيْءٍ, and he didn't come back with anything. He died and he saw all of his money got destroyed in the battle. That individual, he's better. But a person who comes back with either one of the two is what? It's not better. Allahu Akbar. Ibn Rajab's kalam is what I'm going to read on you all, and inshallah I will conclude there. He says, وَقَدْ دَلَّ هَذَا الْحَدِيثُ, this hadith indicated, عَلَى أَنَّ الْعَمَلَ فِي أَيَّامِهِ, that the days, the actions in these days, أَحَبُّ إِلَى اللَّهِ, is more beloved to Allah. مِنَ الْعَمَلِ, any actions, فِي أَيَّامِ الدُّنْيَا, from the other days of the days of the year. مِنْ غَيْرِ اسْتِثْنَاءِ, without any exception. شَيْءٍ مِنْهَا, any exceptions. Even the last 10 days of Ramadan. وَإِذَا كَانَ أَحَبَّ إِلَى اللَّهِ فَهُوَ أَفْضَلُ عِنْدَهُ. If it's the most beloved to Allah, then it becomes what? The most virtuous. وَقَدْ وَرَدَ هَذَا الْحَدِيثُ بِلَفْظٍ. And this hadith has been narrated also in another wording. مَا مِنْ أَيَّامٍ. That there isn't no days. العمل, the righteous actions. فيها أفضل. That they are more virtuous. من أيام العشر, these 10 days. وإذا كان العمل, if the actions are what? في أيام العشر أفضل, if it's more virtuous. وأحب, and it's more beloved. إلى الله, to Allah. من العمل في غيره, in other than the days of the year, كلها, صار العمل فيه, then the actions come in it. وإن كان مفضولا, even if the action in other, if actions have ranks, then all the same. So the smallest actions is better than what you could do in any other year. Whether that action is mafdhul, it's low, whether it's fadil, it's high, these 10 days there is nothing like it, whatever you do in it. And the Prophet explained that. He said, وَلَا الْجِهَادُ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. Ibn Rajab says, ثُمَّ اسْتَثْلَى جِهَادًا وَاحِدًا. Only one thing the Prophet, he done an exception from. Which is what? The jihad, the person who loses his wealth and he loses himself. That person is high in rank. وَصَاحِبُ أَفْضَلُ النَّاسِ دَرَجَّةً عِنْدَ اللَّهِ. That person is higher of rank to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَأَمَّا بَقِيَّةُ أَنْوَاعِ الْجِهَادِ. As for other than the other types of jihad, فَإِنَّ الْعَمَلَ, the action a person can do, في عَشْرِ ذِي الْحِجَّةِ, these 10 days, what he can do, أَفْضَلُ وَأَحَبُّ إِلَى اللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ مِنْهَا وَكَذَلِكَ سَائِرَ الْأَعْمَالِ. And all the other actions. وَهَذَا يَدُلُّ. And this is an indication. على أن العمل المفضول في الوقت الفاضل يلتحق بالعمل الفاضل في غيره ويزيد عليه بمضاعفة ثوابه وأجره. If a person does an action which is low in rank, at a time when the time is big, that low passes the other virtuous actions in the other times of the year. Does that make sense? So if a person does a righteous action in other than these 10 days, so he goes in these other than these 10 days, he goes and he fasts. He fasts. Is fasting a high rank reward? Yeah. Yes, it is. He does it. And another person who says, Subhanaka Allahumma wa bihamdik. I'm a person who says, La ilaha illallah, wahdahu la sharika la, lahu al-mulk wa lahu al-hamd, yuhi wa yumit, wa huwa ala kulli shay'in qadir. Are they the same? And the one that fasts? No, the one that fasts is higher. And the one that says that is lower. The one that says that in the month of, in these 10 days, in those 10 days, is higher than the one who fasts any other days in the year. So everything is high this month. And the righteous actions are multiplied more than the other times when it's multiplied. In these 10 days that a person has to comprehend. And then he goes into some of the aqwal and the things that they used to do. So fast these days. Fast. Give sadaqah. Recite the Quran as much as you can. Do good khair. Inshallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward us all with it. Na'am, faddal.